This is Catherine Schmer at Chattanooga State Community College. This is video one on the dot product. The dot product of vectors U, defined to be U1, U2, U3, and vector V, defined to be V1, V2, V3, is U dot V equals U1 times V1, plus U2 times V2 plus U3 times V3. So essentially what I'm doing is I'm multiplying the two x components of the vectors together, multiplying the two y components of the vectors together, and multiplying the two z components of the vectors together, and then adding the results. So note that the dot product result is a scalar. You do not get a vector as your answer, you just get a number. Here is the basic dot product properties. U dot V equals V dot U, so it has a commutative property, meaning you can switch the order. U dotted with parentheses V plus W equals U dot V plus U dot W, so it has a distributive property. You can distribute over addition. The vector scalar C times vector U dotted with vector V equals U dotted with scalar C times vector V equals scalar C times vectors U dot V. So there's scalar multiplication. So that means if you have a number in there, you can just pull it out front and do your dot product and then distribute your number. Or you wouldn't even be distributing, you would just be multiplying by your number. Okay, the fourth property is U dotted with itself equals the magnitude of U squared. And then last, the zero vector dotted with any vector is zero. So you start out with a zero vector, you dot it, and you end up with the scalar zero, so just the number zero. All right, here is the geometric definition of the dot product. And what the geometric definition does is it says if theta is the angle between the vectors U and V, then U dotted with V equals the magnitude of U times the magnitude of V times cosine of theta. So one really important fact that we use a lot is we know that cosine of 90 degrees equals zero. So two vectors are orthogonal or perpendicular if and only if their dot product is zero. So if you have a question that says, are these two vectors 90 degrees to each other, then you just take their dot product. And if the dot product is zero, then yes, they're 90 degrees to each other. If the dot product is not zero, then they are not 90 degrees. Example one from the guided notes asks us to find U dot V, the magnitude of U, and the magnitude of V. Then find the angle between the vectors U equals square root of 3i minus 7j, and V equals square root of 3i plus j minus 2k. So I'm going to find the dot product first. And remember, by the definition, I just multiply the corresponding components together and add the results. So I'm going to have the I components multiplied together is square root of 3 times square root of 3, plus the j components multiplied together, negative 7 times 1, plus the k components multiplied together. And notice vector u does not have a k component, so that is 0. So I'll have 0 times negative 2. So I get, simplifying this, I get 3 minus 7 plus 0, which gives me negative 4. So the dot product of U and V is negative 4. Now I want the magnitude of vector U, and I know that's the square root of each component squared, so the square root of 3 squared plus negative 7 squared, So that gives me the square root of 3 plus 49, which simplifies to the square root of 52. Magnitude of V is the square root of the square root of 3 squared plus 1 squared plus negative 2 squared, which gives me the square root of 3 plus 1 plus 4, which simplifies to the square root of 8. Now I know I could break this down further because 4 is a perfect square and it's a factor of 8, so I could break this down into 2 square root of 2, but I'm just going to leave it for the time being because we're going to use it to find the angle between the two vectors. So using u dot v equals the magnitude of u times the magnitude of v times cosine of theta, where remember theta is the angle between the two vectors. I'm going to plug in the numbers that I just found above. So negative 4 equals the square root of 52 times the square root of 8 times cosine theta. So I have that cosine theta equals, I'm going to divide both sides by the number that was attached to cosine theta. So I get cosine of theta equals negative 4 divided by the quantity square root of 52 times square root of 8. So think about, if you have cosine of theta equals a number, how do you find the angle? You take the inverse cosine. So that's what we're going to do to find theta. We have theta equals the inverse cosine of negative 4 over the quantity square root of 52 times square root of 8. Be really careful with how you enter this in your calculator. You want to make sure that you put parentheses around the denominator so that your calculator knows that both of those square roots are in the denominator. So that gives me 1.8 radians. If you want to get a degree answer, just make sure your mode is in degrees. If you want radians, make sure your mode is in radians in your calculator.